to Amapu village in Ikwano local government of Abia State. We are here today to take a little documentary on the procedure of bee harvesting and honey production. It's really a very complex process and it's not easy at all. And today you get to discover why, or rather what makes honey so expensive. This is what honey harvesters go through to harvest honey for the consumption of the public. It's a very tedious process. I'm about to go into a battlefield with the bees as we are trying to get honey from. With me here is a honey harvester by name Samuel, and reporting live is also a media personnel by name Samuel. You can see the bees hovering around the person harvesting them. You can see it. It's really a tedious process. Harvesting process is really complex. Now he's trying to harvest the honey from the place where the bees are located. You can see them in their little quantity, but they are very, very terrible. Now talking about honey is a very, very important natural, let me say, mineral, especially in this part of the world, in Africa, in Nigeria. It's a very medical solution to so many types of diseases and issues. It's recommended by many health practitioners and by many world researchers. Honey has been known as one of the greatest minerals in the world. Especially for people who are diabetic, it is known as a very good remedy for diabetics as a whole. It's so much. Okay, so this is it. You can see the honey there right now. This is it. So this is how they have been extracted. Yes. So this is what makes honey so expensive. Right, it costs almost over 1,000 naira. Over 1,000 naira for even a little quantity. When you talk of a normal little bottle, you can calculate it, almost 5,000 naira. You can see. Okay. So at this point, we are going to leave him to continue to illustrate what he's doing right now. Okay. Over to you, Samuel.
My name is Samuel Ebu. I'm a beekeeper, and I've been in this business for 3 years.
Okay, please help me. This is honey.
There's honey on it.
Please make use of the smoke.
This is called smoker.
Okay. What does
it do? To weaken the bees.
Okay. So please help use it on me a little. Okay, thank you.
To distract them because they work with communication.
Okay.
In this smoker, they won't be working with communication anymore.
Okay.
They'll be scared because it's a kind of jockey.
Hmm.
Yeah. So, honey is a lucrative business.
Okay. Very well. So now I would like to ask you a few questions right now. How did you come into this business? What inspired you to go into this kind of business?
What inspired me to go into this kind of business is that I have been looking for a business that one can do and also engage him or herself into another business. Like as a civil servant and a beekeeper.
Yes.
You can match both of them. Merging both of them, it will consume your time.
Okay.
Unlike other agricultural produce.
Okay.
That will take you time to feed them.
Right.
Monitor them.
Mm-hmm.
But this one, you harvest twice per year.
Okay, so what are you particularly doing?
Okay, I just removed the part that is not
harvested. Okay, okay.
Yes. How do you? That, we sort it. Okay. That's why we harvest with our knife.
Okay. It's really a complex process. Yeah, very well. So, what process are we now? What do you call this process? Is this the harvesting?
This is harvesting process. Okay. So after the harvesting, you go through the processing. Now, the quantity we expected to recover from this hive, we expected to recover 1.2 liters bucket.
Wow,
and we hope that it will be filled up at the end of the harvest.
Okay, okay. In this manner, right?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Then after this, what do you do next? Because looking at this, I can see that this is not the real. This is not a real liquid honey, the consumer product that we used to see. So what after this, what now brings it down to that very level that we consume?
What brings it down to that level is we have processing machine.
Okay.
Pressing machine.
Okay.
That when you put the wax in this machine, the machine will now press it.
Okay.
And extract the honey.
Okay.
Why the wax has 300 industrial use.
Wow.
It's not a waste.
Okay, that is, you can use it,
you can use
in
it
about 300
industrial use.
Different ways.
Ways.
Okay, that's interesting.
Number one, you can use it as a candle. It's a candlestick.
Wow. Okay.
Number two, you can use it as a betting instrument.
Wow. I'm sure if you keep mentioning all of them, it will take a long time.
So,
that's interesting.
Let's proceed. This is cut off bars. As you are raising it up,
okay.
Let's start it on.
How are these ones being created, if I may ask?
Okay.
Oh, the bees that create them for what?
There's one good thing about this hive. The hive is artificial, while the honey is natural.
Okay.
Because they travel places to gather different type of bees, different type of blossom.
Okay.
Produce this honey.
Okay.
We are not the ones that planted the blossoms.
Okay.
So they move far.
And just come to deposit them
here. Just come to deposit them here.
So what makes them to use there as a location? What attracts them?
Okay, just like a hive. This is called Kenya Toba.
Okay.
It's conducive for them.
Alright.
So it's well built. Good material. So when they discovered a hive like this,
yes,
it's an avenue for them to start depositing honey.
Okay. When working with these things, you have to be very, very conscious. Once again, for our viewers who are just joining us, like I said, this is just a procedure, a process for harvesting of honey. We are trying to see how honey is harvested, and we are today located in the eastern part of Nigeria, in Abia State precisely, Ikwano local government area, in a bee farm, a beehive. This is what honey harvesters like our guest today, with the name Samuel Epo, goes through, just to harvest honey that finally comes out as the final consumer product which you consume. It's expensive because it's a very tedious process of production. It goes through a very tedious process of production. This is what honey has to go through. This is the honey you consume. Now, as we continue interviewing our guest, Mr. Samuel, tell us some of the benefits of the consumption of honey.
Honey helps in many ways.
Okay.
I may not be able to mention,
but you can just tell us a few very important and major ones.
The major one is for a patient that has stomach ulcer,
okay,
it has internal healing,
okay,
for stomach ulcer,
okay,
for arthritis,
okay,
which comes from the bee sting.
Wow, so you mean by one of these bees stinging someone now, like myself, it will bring a cure to arthritis if I had arthritis.
If you have arthritis.
Wow, that's
highly medicinal.
So that's to say the fluid that is in of them is used by medical practitioners to work on arthritis patients.
Yes.
Wow, that's a very nice one. Okay, then what other benefit of it do we have? Okay. Wow.
Now, instead of using industrial heaters,
okay,
which is poisonous to the body, we hope money. Increase your sugar level.
As this video is going on, you can also drop your comments for any questions you have, any inquiries you would like to make. We also like to let you know that the person we are interviewing today actually commercializes this honey. He sells the honey in large quantity, in smaller quantity. He is a good partner with most big firms around, pharmacies, hospitals, eateries, catering organizations, and all of that. He does supply. He has people who supply for him as well. He is a merchant in the business. So he also trains people who are interested in, you know, empowering themselves in this manner. This is like a very strong empowerment. You can imagine, I was shocked the day he told me that a 25 liter gallon of this kind of the final product of this, which is honey, pure honey rather, original honey, costs as much as approximately 100,000 naira currently. So tell me, when you have such kind of initiative like this, why would anyone want to say that there are no jobs in the country with such things like this? So you can see, this is a very good empowerment for self. There's no business or, let's say, entrepreneurial stride that doesn't have challenges. You can already see this one of the challenges of this one. You have to fight with the bees. You have to be in the battlefront every time. By the end of the day, you have cause to smile when you start counting your money as a bee and honey investor. You can see, he's trying to work on the new hive to open it. And the same process we saw in the other recording, in the other hive, he's also doing the same here, extracting the bee contents that will later be processed and finally will become honey that we know. And he's doing this in an army of, in the presence of an army of bees, you know, attacking and trying to penetrate.
Hive is highly productive.
Okay.
And when you come across a hive like this,
yes,
you have every cause to smile.
Yes.
Because with this hive, with all my strength, I will be unable to lift it up.
Okay.
And looking at it, I'm expecting not less than,
wow,
20 liters of honey.
Wow. So how long?
Particular hive.
How, sorry, let me cut you here. How long does it take to fill up this wood?
So I visited this hive last July.
Yes.
So counting from July till now,
that
it has filled from the starting to the end.
That is almost about 6 months.
6 months.
Wow.
So, and I'm coming back here in March.
Okay.
By March, either I get a filled up honey or half of it by March.
Okay. Wow. That's so interesting.
We harvest twice per year.
Okay. Does the weather affect it? Like, if it's in the rainy season, does it affect it?
Yes, weather do affect it.
Okay.
But you also, as a beekeeper, you monitor the weather.
Okay. So if it's going to be a rainy season, what is the remedy? What do you do? Is water allowed to touch it?
If it's a rainy season, there are days that it's not really rainy.
Okay.
So you go those days that water will not affect the honey.
Okay.
Because honey extracts the environment. Honey work with the environment.
Okay.
If there is water around the environment,
yes,
it affects the honey too.
Okay, so it will not be able to
will not be able to come out with a good product.
Wow, okay, okay. So this is actually what you refer to as natural honey, isn't it?
Yes.
Okay, that's very good.
I am a mountain, I am a tall tree, oh, I am a swift wind, sweeping the country. I am a river, down in the valley, oh, I am a vision, and I can see clearly. If anybody asks you who I am, just stand up tall, look them in the face and say, that star up in the sky, from that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it, I'm the world's greatest. And I'm that little bit of hope, when my back's against the ropes, I can feel it, I'm the world's greatest. I am a giant, I am an eagle, oh, I am a lion down in the jungle. I am a marching band, I am the people, oh, I am a heaven hand, I am a hero. If anybody asks you who I am, just stand up tall, look them in the face and say, that star up in the sky, from that mountain peak up high. Hey, I made it, I'm the world's greatest. And I'm that little bit of hope, when my back's up against the ropes, I can feel it, I'm the world's greatest.
In the ring of life, I'll rain love,
I will rain,
and the world will know.
Against the wall, I can feel
the world's greatest.